minerals. I mean, it's we, our body temples are amazing if we take good care of it. Right now, they got us eating so much food that is not good for us, really, and we pay a dear price. So, I like to buy primarily about 80-85% or more of my what I eat is organic. Okay. People say, well, isn't that expensive? But yeah, you know, but getting sick, okay? You get a hospital bill. You go in emergency. You get about $300 bill up in there, okay? So I'd rather spend a little more to take care of me better than to call myself taking a shortcut and paying a deeper price on the other thing. So that's why Joe Lewis said you can run, but you can't hide. And so I'm saying, all of you have a divine temple. Our bodies are designed to do some wonderful things and some high endurance, but we must take care of it. If we do not, we pay the price, okay? So, with five, Thursday is their worst day. Three is their most stressed number. Now, Donald Trump is a five. He's born on the 14th day of the month. March is one of his worst months. January, March, and December. And so you see what's happening for March. March is almost, as it ended, it's almost a wrap, okay? He'll probably be impeached too. But anyway, that's his problem. Nonetheless, number six people. Six people born on the 6th, 15th, to 24th. Okay, or any Tauruses or Libras in the house, they're number six. Six rules allergies, the nose, the throat, the upper part of the lungs. Six rules the voice. That's why six people are very magnetic. Like Bob Marley was a number six. Martin Luther King is a number six. You know, when you hear about a half a cent, you know Martin Luther King is from. Okay? There's no question who we listen to. So it rules that part of the body, the respiratory part. It rules asthma, hay fever, heart palpitations, irregular blood circulation. With the women, I noticed, it also rules the mammary gland. So number six women are either well-developed in that area, or they're very, very sensitive, where the first thing you'll do is come home and take off your latex, one, whatever you're wearing. I understand you're working room. I don't know. I'm just saying what somebody told me. Anyway, the most stressful day for sixes is always on a Sunday. Okay, I don't know whether you remember, but when George W. Bush was elected, second, on a Sunday, Super Bowl Sunday, he choked on something he was eating. Well, he was born on a six, and that happened on a Sunday, which is one of a six's worst days. Okay, so these things make no sense. So ask yourself, what happens? What, you know, if you are under the weather, if you're not feeling good, if you gotta go into the hospital, make a mental note of these things. The help is the only thing you got. Life is not a video game. You get zapped, that's it. Okay? Somebody told me, they said, yeah, well, you know, I'll come back. I'll wait till my next life. Well, in the next life, God may assign me to be a butterfly, pollinating the plants, okay? It's the same as being a human being, looking at all the beautiful ladies, how good your look, and all the things I want to do. You know, it's a big, big difference. Big, okay? So what I'm saying is, in this existence, take care of yourself. Nobody else is going to do it for you. Trust me on this. Don't wait till you get sick. This is one of the few so-called civilized countries, although it acts very uncivilized toward certain people, whereby they don't take a preventive approach. There's no money in making being well. For example, do you know when you pay your credit cards, and by the way, I will get to residents, when you pay your credit card bills on time, they call you a deadbeat? Yes, they do. Don't they know that? You are a deadbeat. You're not supposed to pay your bills on time. They're not going to make no money. This country is about making money. There's this product out called MMS. Some product is where it used the chemicals from the stomach and other stuff, $21. FDA is fighting it. If the solution is only $21, you don't think they're going to pay that. They have a cure already for diabetes, but they can't make anything. Okay? So what I'm saying is this country, instead of it being human driven, unfortunately it seems to be only profit driven. And we pay the price for it too. We really do. By going to the hospitals, all these. I think they got this EpiPen $700-$800. They got chemo drugs in the thousands of dollars. Just the anxiety alone. And you know, they now recognize stress as a disease too. and we're all stressed, especially with this guy we got here. He messed up the whole almost world relationship within 90 days. That's incredible. You know? I mean, really, think about it, man. Acting like an a-hole. You know, don't want to shake Angela Merkel's hands. I mean, even if politics says, you know what I'm saying? You know I don't like you, I'm shaking your hand because there's a photo op. Okay, he ain't going to do that. Oh, by the way, he did present her with a bill that Germany owed. Did you know that?
Yeah, they sure did.
He handed her a bill.
Sure did.
He didn't let his team do it. He handed her the bill. I guess he called that cute. So I know this is not going to go anywhere. And these people are having a lot of regrets. They talk about by remorse. No, it's worse than that. Anyway, so with number sevens, Saturday's the most stressful day, and especially in January. Number eight, how many people here are born on... Oh, no, I didn't do the set. I did the set. Sorry.
Yeah, the month.
Sorry. So, Sunday's a stress day, and February and August are stress months, the number sixes. Number sevens. Who's here born on the 7th, the 16th, that's me, or the 25th? We suffer with worry. We love to worry. If everything's okay, we'll make up something to worry on. Not all sevens, but most sevens. Sevens also suffer with night sweats. So I know a lot of sevens like to sleep with practically nothing on, which is none of my business. Being a seven, I will vouch for me, how I like to sleep, okay? Sevens also are inclined to imagine that things are worse than they are, and yet sevens have very good ideas if they only care about them. The seven is the worry sign. That's the sign if nobody else worries better than them. So here's a trick I learned. That's like me telling you in this room, don't think of the color orange. Guess what you're gonna do? Everybody's so orange. And I would tell myself, Lloyd, you worry, you worry. Stop worrying. And you know what happened? I just worried more. And I said one day, and I psyched myself, see, that's all it was, psyched myself. And I said, you know, Lloyd, you know you love to worry. You worry about everything. And you worry about this. And you worry about that. And you worry about the kids. And so and so. Man, by the time I got finished, I stopped worrying. But that's how I do it. So, I mean, I still have concerns or worry, but I worry less because it's not as automatic as it is trying to push it away. So instead of me pushing it away, I embrace it, if that makes sense. All right, anyway, Saturday's the most stressful day in January, kind of stressful month. Number eight people, born on the 8th, the 17th, the 26th, or under the sign of Capricorn. Number eight? All right. Eights like fours tend to be misdiagnosed. My mother was an eight. I would go when, just before she passed, I was in the hospital, and I would tell the doctors, okay, my sister said, doctors, we're G-O-D. If any doctors in here, please don't take it personal. That's what I was told, okay? And they could not quite pinpoint. How many number eights in here again? Okay. Have y'all ever been to a doctor and they pinpointed it first time? Have you ever gone? Annette? Your name is Annette, right?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, you November 17th, right? Yeah, you're the first person I saw when I came in here. Okay. You ever been, have you gone to the doctor, have they ever got it right? Does it make sense?
No.
Yeah. But eight moves headaches, it moves the knees, the teeth, the bones, it moves constipation or stoppage of the intestines. Okay, so psyllium seed is very good. It also moves blood poisoning. And for example, there's a guy I know who's an eight, and he had to go to the hospital because he was taking so much medicine, he had kind of poisoned himself with toxicity. So eights tend to do that. And I always tell eights to try to have, because of constipation, one or two meatless meals a week. And the stressful days for number eight in Capricorn is always on a Wednesday and a Sunday. Okay. Finally, number nine, saving the best for last.
And the month.
The stress months, thank you, dear. Hey, buddy. The stress months are February, June, August, and September. Have you ever been sick around those times?
Not
that you want to look for it. Good. But what I'm saying is, listen, just as the sun rises, it sets. Same with our lives. We have cycles of life, ebbs and flows. That's the reality of it, okay? Finally, number nine. Is anybody here born on the 9th, 18th, or 27th of any month? Or under the sign of Aries or Scorpio?
Virgo.
Okay. You said Virgo? kind of missed it, but we'll start again. Nine people, nine is governed by the element of fire. Thus, diseases and illnesses don't like fire. But accidents, injuries, and harm from knives and guns and scissors and sharp instruments, those are the things. Give me an example. If you watch a movie, they'll tell you when you go abroad, before you drink water, what do? You boil it. You use fire. You've seen those old cowboy movies, okay? Before they took the bullet out the cowboy's shoulder, they stick the knife in fire first, kill off the bacteria, whatever, then pull it out. So nine being a fire number, when they go to the hospital, that's because they either visited or because they just had a bad break, a bad spill, an accident. And I always tell nine people, please don't play around with people that, you know, when they play around with guns and knives. Every year, countless people are killed from, I didn't know the gun was loaded. Those happen to be a lot of nine people or Aries or Scorpio people. So please don't. Nine, because it is, alcohol is it's interesting. When the Native Americans were, the indigenous people of this nation, was introduced to alcohol by the Europeans that came here, they described it as firewood. Well, that's a nine. And I always tell number nine people, don't get too comfortable with alcohol, like five shouldn't get too comfortable with sex, drugs, or drinking. Okay? Yeah, alcohol. And because because nine is a confrontational energy, and alcohol don't help. It's like a meek, mild-mannered guy going into a bar, and he has a couple of drinks, and he thinks he can kick everybody's butt up in the bar. That's the alcohol. See what I'm saying? So when a nine and that alcohol get together, they'll have blackouts, they'll do things or say things which they cannot take back. So all of you are divinely important. All of you best take care of your health. But this pharmaceutical company is pitching all kinds of drugs we use to buy and use, and we're actually killing ourselves. And in fact, when Dr. Africa comes on the 30th of this month, he has a book called Pills That Kill, and he lists all these pills that we take and all the side effects that will only shorten your life in the end, okay? So with that, I want to let you know I'm doing readings over in the corner. This is my book. And by the way, in my book, I also got Herbs and Health is Very Good for You. But this presentation is for Sister Maya. And so although I could talk forever, because I love this subject, it's really not about me. It's about her. Is she ready?
No, that's it.
Okay.
Anybody have any questions?
Yeah. The worst day for the number nine is a Monday. And the worst day for the month of the number nine is always in the month of late June into July. Okay? All right, now, let me tell you a little bit about me. Yes? Oh, that's right, you had a question. I'm sorry, darling.
While you were doing the 1 through 9, I found myself falling in 2 different categories. Which one do we do? I was in number one, and then I also you call whatever it
is. What's your sign?
Capricorn.
Okay, so I would take it, you're saying you either born December 28th, April 1st, April 10th, or April 19th. See? Got them person?
But you didn't say that as number one, December.
No, but here's what I'm going to do. That's why I said make note that you are a number as well as a sign. And that's one of the ways I do it. Then there are other ways, but I can't take your answers. Anyway, I'm Lloyd Strayhorn. Thank you. Go to my website, lloydstrayhorn.com. You can get readings, you can schedule appointments. I live in Harlem. I do many readings over there. And again, I've got some books. And it'd be great to get in your business. All right? I'm nosy. But I know I'm nosy. See, I own it. Yeah.
Thank you. Give Rob a round of applause. We're online. Go over here. Live streaming. Yeah, you said you 1-800. Give me a 1-800
note. Yeah, I forgot. 1-800-581-4401.
Slowly for those who are slow.
Yes. 1-800-581-4401. Oh, and by the way, I do have an online course to teach you how to do this. I taught at City College, everything. And the course is only $19.99. Okay. You know, that's all. It's called learnfromlloyd.com. Just that simple. Learnfromlloyd.com. LLOID. Let's spell it right. Let us not give anybody else some credit. Thank you.
Wait a minute.
And he said, is the live stream taken? You got questions for the live stream?
Yeah.
Well, if anybody got any questions on the live stream, please, you can question Lloyd right now or call him at
1-800-581-4401.
But they got a question? Anybody got a question?
If you live in Benin.
Oh, yeah, and this is my book. I wrote six of these, but this is my classic book. Yes, my October 28th thing. Hi, honey. Where's your hubby at?
I'm representing.
Oh, okay, okay. All in your business, right? Yes.
All right, I see people in the library.
Yes, you're in my head because I was going to say, in addition to this main book, I have three other books I published last year. One of them is called Lloyd's Numbers in Your Workbook, to teach you how to do this if you don't go online. Then book number two I published last year was Lloyd's Numbers in Your Relationship Guide, how to find that soulmate, okay, without nosing. I'm telling you, if y'all want me to get in your business, I'm the one. Okay, I ain't gonna tell nobody, but I'm gonna keep on. And then my classic one is Lloyd's Book of Numbers, the 21st Numerology Guide for the 21st Century. All these can be purchased at Amazon, Barnes and Noble, whatever it is. Okay, so thank you for mentioning that. I forget to plug myself.
Question from the live stream. What's that? No question. Oh, wait. Give him a round of applause. Give him a round of applause.
Yeah, it's a lively audience in Brooklyn
in the house. We're not too far from where Biggie was, you know, Notorious B.I.G. We're right here. I grew up in this area right here. This is my area. Yeah. All right, those who know, know. Those Bed-Stuy, do or die, that's right. I was in Clinton Hill, I was in fourth grade, I was in Bed-Stuy, I was in PS 11, same school that you went to, but I'm not the same age. I was a little older. And my sister, I think, went to that. So, who from Bed-Stuy? Anybody from Bed-Stuy? I guess y'all ran already. Okay, do that. Do or die. All right, well, yo, see, I'm from Flatbush too, haven't I? Yeah, I'm from Flatbush also. I'm in Flatbush right now. Flatbush, Erasmus, I went to. Well, I went to three schools. I got kicked out of all three of them. I'm not proud of that, but I'm doing much better. Stop playing. I am making some money.
I'm sorry, one of my students told me to remind you, I also do palmistry too. Your hands do everything. Let me tell you, your hands have more. I can tell you when you're married, how many children you had. This is great stuff I do, trust me.
Thank you.
And how to smack the hell out of somebody with one palm. And you put their whole mark on it. See all them lines? All of a sudden, you got the palm and his whole reading on your hand. But it is what it is, all right? But we're getting ready for Ma, and Lloyd is a great person. Give Lloyd a round of applause. He's been on so many shows. He does stuff all over the world. I am one of his students. She is one of his students. You could be one of his students. When I do teach class, I won't teach it like him. I'll teach it a little different. But because when Lloyd teaches class, he always says, take it and teach it the way you would teach it. Me, my acronym for my type of class is called BATH, B-A-T-H, BATH, or B, you know, someplace depending on where you come from, BATH or BATH. All right? In Jamaica, I said BATH. Go BATH, no? Well, I'm going to take you. BATH. No, but BATH means beyond. When I deal with the numbers, I look beyond the numbers. I look around the numbers. I look through the numbers, and I hear the numbers. So I'll teach you how to do that. Because you have, every one of us have some type of intuition. Even you out there. You have an intuition, and some of us don't pay attention. Women seem to pay attention to their women's intuition a little bit more than men. Sometimes we roll dice. We don't care. Yeah, she looks clean. she a crackhead on the street. Yeah, she looks good. Okay, well, we gonna try it. I got a condom. See, that's what we do, but it's true. We roll dice. Women, you know, it's like men don't like to go to the hospital. Scared. I mean, somebody been trying to push me to go get a colonic, but I just can't think about the colonic right now. Sorry. Because me come from Jamaica, and Jamaica not stick not there. We just know it or not. But it is a heal. It is something that's supposed to be good for somebody. And it does go back to Kemet and all these different. But I, even when my, When my mother tried to stick an enema up in me, I was upset.
Did you go yet?
Huh? I still haven't gone. No, I haven't gone, man. But see, my back, everything is all right. I'm feeling good now. See, I did all the Epsom salt drinks and all that. I did everything that I learned from back in the day. All the stuff that I learned, all the bush me drink. She wants to hold my hand. See, I didn't know all that holding hands. Nobody should. And a one-way exit out. I don't know nothing about nothing two-way about it. I'm staying focused. Stay focused. See, that's why men don't want to get prostate checked. See, and we do have to do it. We do have to do it, brothers. So I'm going to grit my teeth. Eventually. Thank you. Don't tell me Bridget like Shabba and Beanie Man. I said, boy, we don't know why you do that to the bridge here. We know you're not that thing, man. You can't come out Jamaica with that. That's just how they would talk to me like that. But I'm serious. It's about taking care of your health. Take care of your health. It's if you got to go take the prostate exam or take a colonic, whatever. So how many of y'all did a colonic? Ladies, see, ladies, easy. See how easy ladies raise their hand? Yeah, I'm doing it tomorrow. I do it every week. Men ain't going to do that. We probably wouldn't even tell you if we did. I wouldn't tell you. I'm being real. I'm not going to tell you if I did that. But no, I haven't done it. I know. And I know I'm in my health cycle. Like Lloyd was talking about the number four. I'm in my number four year. So what's so funny, and I was expecting some type of health problem to happen. That's how important numbers are to us, because numbers don't lie. People lie to themselves. So stop lying to yourself. We all have a birth certificate. We all born on a certain day. And like Les Brown says, the two most important days of your life is the day you were born and the day you find out why you were born. So that's what numbers help you to do. Numbers ain't the is-all and be-all, nor is astrology. Those are just part of the modalities or the puzzles to help guide you to be your very best. That's all we're trying to do. That's all Lloyd can do. That's all I can do. At the end of the day, either you can go down the negative road or the positive road. It's your choice. You have the willpower to do this. But we just give you the guideline when you come to us for a numerology reading. You come to me over the phone and talk to me. I'm going to get into your business, but I'm going to get into the trauma. Like I know people born, like he was talking about people born under number one. See, Lloyd gives the basics when he appeared, but he got a lot of secrets. But if you find out, you talk to a number one or number three, you find out they have father and daddy issues. Daddy wasn't there. Or there wasn't a good communication between the father. Something like that. That's what pop up. You run into people with twos and sixes, you find there was molestation going on. So you gotta look out for these certain numbers that draw that, because let's say with a six, six are such a natural loving number that they attract, that people sometimes, because man has been hurt and traumatized and women have been hurt and traumatized in this part of the world through slavery and colonialism, some of them attract the pedophiles and those kind of sexual predators. Certain numbers attract it. Because you have young girls and young boys that are born under certain numbers that just love Uncle this and love them so much, and they give up their love, and that person that is getting the love don't know how to handle the love. And then they abuse the child. They abuse the women. If I ask how many women got molested, I bet you a number of y'all would raise your hands. A lot of y'all would raise your hands. Because Oprah done opened the door for a lot of y'all. And other people opened the door. I'm happy for Poppy and Ron Savage that revealed about Bam from Brooklyn, African American, because now men are starting to talk about it. When they wouldn't talk about this. Who wants to talk about somebody their uncle molested them? Nobody wants to talk about that. So we're here to try to help you break your trauma. And I don't force the issue. Once I see all the numbers and I say, okay, she ain't gonna talk about it, but I start hearing the crying and the sniffling on the phone and all kinds of stuff. And I said, you got the sixes. I tell especially people born on the six or the two. I said, forgive, but don't forget, because you have to let go in order for you to grow when these things have happened to you. You have to let go in order for you to grow. Very important. So I don't care what you're going through, what trauma you've been through. It's all about breaking the cycles for us, helping you to break your cycle and be prepared so you don't pass it on to your child. Because these cycles can go on to your children. And I really explain that to people. When you hear that so-called biblical quote that says the sins of the father shall fall upon the child to the third and fourth generation, that's not just a biblical quote. That is a scientific thing, because it's all dealing with the DNA and the bloodline. I remember, and before I bring on Ma, I remember I wanted to kill myself. Yes, I wanted to take myself out in a nightclub, because I was going through so much stress and trauma with my ex-wife at that time and all that, and I didn't know what to do. I was gonna take my life. Then I talked to my father the week after. This is what happened. A woman run up into the club and said, I'm looking for Brother Simon. Simon here? I said, yes, Simon is here. How you doing? I'm Simon, I'm the manager of the club. I was the manager of Temptation right there in Church and Flatbush at the time. And I said, yes, I'm Simon, how you doing, sister? I swear to you, I had an electrical cord ready to go do what I gotta do. This sister ran up and said, I just heard your name on the radio. The brother on the radio said you was a good brother and you're a nice brother, and I need to book this club. And that what she said to me brought so much tears and so much joy to my heart, that somebody is talking to me, talking about me, and I'm not in front of them. Usually, you know, out of mind, out of sight. These people are talking about me on the radio and saying how much of a good brother I should come to you and book Temptations anytime you want. She ran up in that club. You know that sister never booked the club. She just came to say what she needed to say on that day. And that year, I was in my 4 year, in my 4 month. And usually the 4 years or the number four is a number of one when people can hurt themselves, or a number of suicide. In Lloyd's book, it's in Lloyd's book. So we got to understand these different modalities. And how do you offset the number four? You offset the number four, or those depressive numbers like 4 and 7, by at least keeping yourself motivated. Anybody born on the number four or have the four energy around them, stay motivated. Listen to motivation speaking, affirmations every morning, because your brain activates on a higher octave early in the morning. So what you put in early in your morning, it helps you to carry you throughout the day. So don't listen to the news, especially number fours and number seven. Don't watch the news, because the first 25 minutes, quote unquote, is negative news in the morning. So we need to stay focused. Y'all get what I'm saying? So you see why me and Lloyd, it's so important to come to one of our numerology sessions, or go to an astrologer, or go to Sister Yendez with the yoni steaming and all that. The experience that she has with these people, man, if Yendez explained it, man, she'll bring tears to your eyes. That's how deep it is. So go to these people like Uncle Rising Sun that do the Oregon energy healing and the crystal healing, the chakra healing. Come to the healing circle here every Tuesday. We do the circle here every Tuesday, where California does the chakra healing. Then you have Sister Gina that does the tarot reading. Then you have the massage. Then you have all types of modalities, all types of readers, just to help guide you. Like I said, it is not the is-all or be-all. It's just a guide, a part of the puzzle to help balance you out and make you your wisest and greatest person that you can be in your life. That's all we're here to do. All right? Good. Yeah, you can clap. It's all right. Clap. It's all right. Don't be afraid to clap. My goodness. Show some appreciation. Oh, my goodness. I know this ain't the only product Ma has. Stop playing. I know this ain't it. We're going to sell all of that tonight, Freddie. But don't laugh. Yes. Oh, yeah, go ahead, blend. But you may do it quick. Yeah, we're about to bring on. Oh, yeah. He wants to blend real quick before I bring on Ma. So Ma's voice is real light. You don't want to. I've never heard Ma scream and yell yet. And if she does, it's like, really? I don't know. That's not a scream or a yell. That's just Ma. Give a round of applause to Coconut Rob. How y'all doing, family? Coconut Rob. That's my Hebrew brother doing great work. That's right.